tempoh 2 minggu ini, saudara-saudari dan anak-anak hanya perlu berada di rumah. Just stay at home. Luangkan masa bersama-sama anak, isteri dan ahli keluarga. Tidak perlulah keluar ke mana-mana. Dengan cara ini, saudara-saudari terhindar daripada jangkitan COVID-19 dan penularan wabak ini insyaAllah dapat kita bendung. Inilah tujuan sebenar perintah kawalan pergerakan dilaksanakan oleh kerajaan.
Anda diwajibkan untuk sentiasa memakai pelitup muka semasa berada di stesen dan di dalam tren. Bersama kita putuskan rantaian COVID-19. Attention, it is mandatory for you to wear a face mask at all times while at the station and on board the train. Let's break the COVID-19 chain together.
Thank you. The much-awaited COVID-19 vaccine to boost its fight against the pandemic in Malaysia arrived on a special aircraft Sunday morning. Flight MH604, bearing the Jalo Gemilang livery to symbolise the vaccine is for Malaysians, landed at 10:07 a.m. with the first batch of 312,390 doses of the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine. The arrival of the vaccine will kickstart the National COVID-19 Immunisation Programme, the largest vaccination programme ever in the country. The vaccine has been certified effective and approved by the National Pharmaceutical Regulatory Agency, NPRA, of the Health Ministry. The immunization program is divided into three phases, with the first scheduled from February 26 to April for frontline personnel, including those from the Health Ministry, Armed Forces, Police, Civil Defense Force, and Malaysian Volunteer Department, RELA.
Malaysia recorded 1,208 more COVID-19 cases on Monday, taking the country's total infections to nearly 325,000. Selangor's daily cases continue to show an improvement, although they still have the country's highest number of cases with 379. Sarawak recorded the second highest number of cases, followed by Penang. The Health Ministry also reported 3 more deaths due to the coronavirus, while another 1,973 patients have been discharged. 13 new clusters were discovered, 12 of which are workplace clusters. There are 155 patients currently under intensive care and 70 are receiving ventilator support. Active cases in the country have now gone down to 15,511.